Hi! It's Tuesday! Oh my goodness! I hope everyone had a good weekend. My day today has been dealing with my dog, Tarkin. Tarkin's being a little dramatic today. So, I might need to cut stream short in case he needs something. I got him to chill right now, so he's just hanging out, so it might be fine. So we're still working on this drawing. We were working on the second multicolor, second shading pass, but I think there's some touch-ups I want to do on the first pass. I think I want to introduce the hard line back into here. I spent a lot of my weekend watching coloring tutorial videos. So I hopefully it helps me a little bit while I'm finishing this up. But I think I'm gonna have to take some of the ideas, the suggestions, and apply them to the next piece. That's okay though. There is something I was looking at while I was waiting for stream to start this that I wanted to fix, and I don't remember what that was. Oh, I think it was down here. I think it was... I think I want to go... like this, actually. I also played around with some brushes. Probably try those out on the next drawing. Okay. I got... I was basically trying to read up on when should there be a hard shadow line? And when should there not be? Because I still have such a hard time with shading, honestly, and coloring. I did, you know, cel shaded for so long that like, was a lot more loose. And the shadows just aren't as detailed, right? So I'm trying to get into some more like detailed coloring of shadows, trying to give like more depth to my work. Beach, hi! Beach, teach me how to color. I can't do it. But yeah, as I'm watching all these coloring tutorials, I'm trying to learn some stuff. Like, be a better artist and break out of my comfort zone and learn new skills. But I'm also like, maybe being a cel-shaded chibi artist, that's just me. Maybe I should just stick with what I'm good at. Your last pieces, though, like, well, I liked the coloring in them anyway. I'm using Clip Studio Paint. I actually have 2.0. I don't know if I would recommend getting 2.0. Because it is always online. You forgot how. That's the other thing is, like, if you take a long break from art, like, I do think art's a lot like riding a bicycle. I think that's true, but you also have to remember, like, your style and how you did things, and, like, I'll forget after a week. Procreate has some really cool animation options if you've done any of those yet. Oh, I'm not. I don't know if anyone really remembers Anatomy, to be fair. Have a lot of emote friends that use the animation tools in Procreate, which. Honestly, it looks so, I say easy. I know there's a learning curve to it, but it's a lot easier than like Clip Studio. And I like don't offer animated emotes right now because they're just so much effort for me to do versus doing them in Procreate. At least that's what it seems like to me. Yeah, I heard that it like that one's really nice too. And then there's another animation program that people like to use that's also only on the iPad, so like that doesn't help me. Like CapSwing or something like that. Yeah, I'm just sitting here. I'm like, surely, guys, surely there's a PC option you could give me. Stupid customers. It's also fine. Your work's technically work should be more important than me. I'm using Stylus. Was like, how do I show you? I don't have my cam on right now. Hang on. me see if I can. Oh, they don't. Okay. I was like, how do I show you the Wacom I'm using? Hang on. So this is my drawing tablet. And here's the stylus. It's down here. So I'm gonna whack on. I have a video of my entire setup. I can link it in Discord if you want to look at it. So I have a video that shows. Well, hang on, I can just show you guys. I can show you guys. Hang on. Where is it? We'll get to it. Somewhere down here. Load. Okay. See, there's my. I have it on this arm here. So it's an ergonomic, it's an Ergotron arm. It is pretty expensive, but I thought if it was going to be holding, taking care of my very expensive screen tablet, it should be a good arm. And then I do have arms for my monitors, so I can move them around. I say move them around, I don't really move them much. And then I have the very important gamer keyboard that lights up. And yeah, I use a clip mic right now. My decorations. Well, that's my Figma, but. Because you know your area has to be cute. Or at least I want my area to be cute. I just think your desk space should you should find it aesthetically pleasing so you enjoy being at it. See, I got twinkle lights. And then, yeah, so I use an old phone, Samsung Galaxy, I think it's a Galaxy 9 for face camming. And then I have a webcam when I VTube. This is what I use as my little spotlight. But yeah. Hooray! It looks like I already came in here a little bit the other day to color in here. Yeah, I think it's so helpful when people show their desks and their setups. So you can get ideas for your own. And then I also understand that my setup is not actually like reasonable or feasible for a lot of people. So I totally get that. Yeah, that's totally fair. I was definitely like, well, if I'm going to draw full time, like that's going to be my job. And especially if I wanted to add streaming into it, I should probably have something ergonomic for that, that's really functional. There's a new mic that I've been looking at. If it goes on sale this holiday season, I'll probably buy it. At the same time, like, I don't want to spend more than I'm making either, you know? I had a pretty long conversation with Dan about like how I view my art career in streaming, 'cause like I'm a pretty small artist still, and you know, being okay with that, and like even though I view this as my job, especially 'cause I'm not well enough to hold like a more traditional office job, and also with how the job market it is, I'm not sure if I could get an office job right now. I'm leaning towards viewing art more like a hobby again and just trying to enjoy it. And yeah. It's so easy to compare yourself to other artists and like try to measure yourself against them. And I feel like I definitely didn't do that when I was working a full-time job and I considered myself a hobby artist. But now that I'm like, art is my job, I find myself comparing more often. And I'm like, I don't think that's really healthy for me. Yeah, I think the other problem is because I view work very like competitively. Oh, thank you, Beach. But I do view work very competitively, which is part of the reason. I mean, I have my health problems, right? And then my health problems are exacerbated by me always like pushing myself at work beyond my capabilities, like my physical capabilities, because I wanted to be good at my job, and I wanted to be recognized for being good at my job, and I wanted to be better than others at my job too. So, yeah, unfortunately, I'm a little competitive with work. I want to be the very best that no one ever was. And it's been really hard for me to unlearn that too. I just need to like get back into, art is fun, it should be fun. Not hold myself to everyone else's metric of what success is, because to be honest, it is very hard to be any like measured level of success as an artist online, really. I considered you an artist, but I know what you mean though, too. Like, sometimes giving yourself that label feels like extra pressure. A good one. I am an artist. I think someone the other day called me a professional artist, and I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. That might be too much. No! I feel like that label, this is so bad. I think you understand what I mean though. Like if you call yourself an artist, you're setting an expectation of not only for what other people should perceive you as, but how you perceive yourself, right? So I don't know if I'm ready to perceive myself as a professional artist. Yeah, I feel like, I don't know, I don't want to be, because there's so much I need to learn and there's so much I struggle with as an artist. I'm afraid of calling myself a professional artist that people will think that I think my art is better than it is. Does that make sense? That I'm like full of myself? As I still want to be the very best that no one ever was, but like... I will probably be the first one to tell you that there's something wrong with my art, like... I wish the haters would hate somewhere else. But I will say, no one's ever been like, that's not true. There has people that have been mean to my face about my art, but not recently. If you go to, are you on your phone or are you on your PC? I see your phone or your tablet. Is your phone okay? If you go to, how do I do that? You have to go to my profile. But I don't remember how you get to the profile when the stream is active on your phone. Because in my profile, there's a widget. And in the widget, you can select your character. And it will follow you around the screen. And if you subscribe, you can pick one of the pet companions to follow you. Oh, is there a little screen avatars icon? I don't know anything about my chat. I'm sorry. I might take it. It might take it a little while to load. I bet she got into the menu now. That reminds me that someday I need to go in and color correct all the sprites. But that's work. That's work. Okay. So now I have left her hair. Her hair is so much. No. Well, it should definitely work on a PC. I hope anyway. I have it on. It's just like, oh, Beach gets nothing. No stream avatars for Beach. Sweep. Oh, is it just your phone? I'm sorry. You got stung by a bee? What'd you do? How'd you manage to get stung by a bee? You're trying to. Oh, I'm sorry. We keep finding massive spiders in our house. And I don't know how or why. Like why they're in the house. What was that? I was coming out of our office, and it was on the wall on the opposite side. Yeah. He was like, "How dare you touch me, peasants?" Wait, have you seen Jupiter Rising? Before I say this next part, no. Okay, to be fair, it's a pretty awful movie. It's really popular, or it was really popular on Tumblr, and it has like Channing Tatum in it and Mila Kunis. And I'm sorry, it's a terrible film. But everyone said like, oh, it's so campy and it's really fun. And so Dan and I watched it. And there's this section with bees. Yeah, so Mila Kunis' character, Jupiter Jones, she's supposed to be royalty, and she just like didn't know because she's been on Earth. And there's a section where like Channing Tatum rescues her, and like they're on the run, and he takes her. They're like out in the country, and there's these bees, and the bees start swarming her, but they don't attack her. They just kind of like follow her around, and they're like, "Bees sense royalty." So I was gonna say, apparently you're not royalty. This bee thinks you're a peasant. Be fair, I think the bee would have stung me too. spider, though. So when I came out of the office and saw the spider, like, I literally, because there's a bathroom next to our office, I ran into the bathroom. Maybe you lost your queenly powers then. Maybe that's it. Oh. I'm excited for this weekend for Chat and Create. I think I'm gonna pull out the new thing I want to work on. Which, if Beach shows up for it, it won't be a surprise anymore. I can't do this. I'm so bad at secrets. You know this about me already, though. I mean, I keep them when it counts. Anything else is like, good luck! What are you gonna work on Saturday? Are you gonna write fic? If Charlie shows up with work, I'm gonna boot her. Toddler's birthday party. Did I ever tell you about one of the kids' birthdays parties I went to when my friend was like really into her keto diet, and so she brought herself keto cupcakes to eat instead of the cake, and of course the kids saw the cupcakes and they're like, oh my god, I want the cupcakes. And she was like, oh yeah, sure, I don't mind sharing the cupcakes. But to be fair, the cake was not, I ate the cake with the kids and it was, oh my god, it was the kids loved it because it was pure sugar. Holy crap. But anyway, so she brought her own keto cupcakes. And of course the kids saw the cupcakes and they're like, oh, I want cupcakes. So she gave some of the kids cupcakes. And again, they're keto. So they used sugar alternatives, which to be fair, I do too sometimes, you know, being diabetic. Beach, thank you for the follow. Ah, you're here, you picked her. You're gonna be Chivisa. But my friend, because the better sugar substitutes are expensive. And she didn't want to spend money on that, which is fine. So she used like, I think it was Splenda or something. Anyway, the cupcakes were awful because she had me try one. Because she's like, oh, if you like them, I'll give you a recipe, you know, being diabetic. And I was like, no way. After I ate one. And then I was watching the kids eat them and they're so excited about the cupcakes because they're cupcakes, right? Jimmy, you suck. Oh, you know, now that I think about it, maybe you have to follow to get the avatar. Maybe that's why you're... Yeah, that's why you finally have one. So I'm watching the kids eat the cupcakes, and like they're so excited because they're cupcakes, and you just see them eating them, and all of a sudden you just kind of see their faces one at a time go, oh. When like the Splenda hits them. Oh yeah, Beechin wrote this really cute Chibusa fic that I got to draw for. It is adorable. She goes on an imaginary space adventure with the Shatena rocks to the Galaxy Cauldron to get their bodies back. That's what it is, okay? I'm not gonna tell her differently. Would you tell Chibusa differently that was in the cauldron? She already had her hopes and dreams smashed, hello? You should. I like that Beach is like, oh no, I hate this character. And Stream Avatar just like, yes, this is the one you were meant to be. Oh man, I can't wait for you to try out the cream stew that involves milk. I hope your kids like it. Dan like loves it. I will say, 'cause cream stew, you traditionally do eat it with rice. You don't have to. I think with bread would be good too. I will say if you eat it with rice, it's better that it is a little saltier. But if you don't eat it with rice, it's you don't need that extra salt. I guess what I would say is like make it so it tastes good to you and then put it over the rice and then see if you need to add more salt or not. But in my experience, that if I put it over rice, a little extra salt makes it taste better. I can't think of the right word, but basically, with the rice, it tastes blander. That sounds stupid. That's not the right word that I'm looking for, but I think you know what I mean. Yeah, that. It cuts the flavor a bit. Oh my goodness, Clip Studio, I'm sorry, please. Okay. I don't understand, because this is not the most intensive piece I've drawn, especially on stream. Like. It's so mad at it right now. I don't get it. Oh, I think it's just rebelling. I don't know. That knot. Do I want like a different color for the overlay? I might have to come over with a. Okay, what I might have to do is above the school dodge layer. I'm gonna have to put an overlay layer. Something like this, I think. I didn't do overlay. Maybe if I just did an add layer. Oh, hi, Beach again! No, yeah, no, that's fine. This is a chill drawing stream, really. My main goal of streaming is that, if people have questions about drawing or my art program, that I can answer them. But otherwise, it's just chilling. I used to play some other music, but and blow, yeah, V-Chan likes to blow people up. I mean, I tried playing some the other day, as startup music for when I did another story, and then I uploaded it, or it got muted on Twitch, and I was like, what the hell? So I was like, okay, I guess I can't use that anymore. I mean, thankfully it was not the actual gameplay, so like, not detrimental to the actual VOD, but yeah. But it used to not be a problem, so I'm extra like, brr, this used to be fine. Apparently. So I want to do. I think so, which means we need to pick one again, and maybe we'll pick one that isn't hard. Big maybe there. Did you want us to pick one for Saturday so you didn't have to write? Is that what you're getting at? No, but yeah. Yeah, you should get out your tablet and practice. But I know it's hard to set aside that time to do it. Thank you. I think you're more dedicated to drawing than I am right now. Are you, you're letting them out? Oh, you have a three-legged baby coming. Alola, hi. Oh no! Poor Lola. But yeah, I could see the kitten having a hard time adjusting to that. Beach. Well, now I can't recognize you because you're not Chips anymore. Who are you? At least you can always change it. You can always go back and change it to something else. If one day you feel like, maybe one day you might feel like Chibs. I don't like that. Let's get that. Okay. Oh no. I feel like I saw someone jumping the other day with their stream avatar, and I was just like, oh no, they're gonna ca- well, I don't know if anyone will catch up to you. I was like, well, someone's coming to take your stars. That's nuts. Someone did have to. I went to look at Facebook and maybe this is a newer thing, but when we were in high school, my high school didn't do this anyway, but my cousin's kid, she's in high school now, and she's doing competitive swimming with the school. And they have this huge banner of her daughter in her swimsuit with her name and that she's on the swim team for that year. And I'm like, is that a thing schools do? Yeah, so my cousin's kid is in high school and she's on the swim team, and they have a big banner of her in her swimsuit with her name and that she's on the swim team this year. Is that a thing? Okay, so I'm not the only one just like, what? Oh, beach. I have so many swim stories. Let me preface, like, where I grew up, we had four season weather, so it got to like 100 degrees in the summer, and then we had like several inches to feet of snow in the winter. Yeah, she just posted the picture of the banner, and it's like huge banner. It's like a floor to ceiling banner of her daughter professionally taking photos of her in her swimsuit, and then it's got like her name on it and the swim year and like all the other fancy graphic stuff on it. Yeah, because it's competitive swim. I did competitive swim growing up too, but it wasn't for the school. I did the summer swim program. In school, I did fast pitch and bowling. But anyway, my high school has a swimming pool, and we would part of PE would be swim classes. Yeah, we have a swimming pool. In part of PE would be swim classes, and like the girls would go in one quarter and then the boys would have it the next quarter. And the boys always had their swim in the winter. And people were always pulling the fire drill at my school. So in the winter, the fire drill would be pulled, and then the guys would have to get out of the pool water and in their swim trunks go stand outside. Let's see, if we want to glow dodge, maybe this warmer orange color. Whoop! Maybe that's too warm. I mean, I loved swimming. So I didn't really think of it at the time as being too annoying. My hair was also really short in high school, and we didn't have to do it in the winter, so I never had to worry about being the one outside. to worry about being a boy. But my high school it was very big. I think I told you guys that there's like 2,000 kids my senior year, and we had three gyms, which two of them were auxiliary gyms. They weren't full-size gyms, but we did have one massive full-size gym with electronic bleachers, and that's where the student body gathered. Okay. I like doing the cheek dots, even though they don't make sense. Then we have here the lines. We want something a little darker. Oh, that's a blending brush, that's why. Oh, it's still. Okay, so we have that, and then we do an overlay layer. All right, Margaret, come on. Oh my goodness. Is this it? Like, do I want? I don't know if I'm sure. I really like the texture it gives. I think that's so nice. Could you add here, and then what if I did, what that is, low dodge. Let me see here. Like, do I want it so warm? Maybe more like that. Oh my goodness. Okay, let me start it. And I feel like, do I want to add some shine spots to the frame? I did. So I have the overlay here. What if I did? If I did glow dodge on that. You know what? No wonder the bee stung you. I think that little, the extra pop's kind of nice, right? I'm sorry. Maybe I'm gonna blur it around here. You left. Okay. Let's see. The background. Let me keep the background as is. Let us over here. Watermark 2. I could stick it in the frame. Actually, I think for this one, I will put it here. And then I think for the watermark version, I'll put it in the frame. Like, when I say the watermark version, I mean the one that I'm going to post like on all the socials. So this will be the big one for Patreon. And then I'll resize it. Can go in here. Think there, and then we will save as the preview version. Okay, and let's open the preview. Change image resolution. Okay. 0.5. Point 0.5 is still decently sized, so let's do 0.75. That's a little bit better. And then I'll show you guys how I use glaze. So glaze is a program that was made to help add, I don't know if noise is the right word, but it adds extra things on top of your art. to make it harder for AI to read it. So if someone feeds your art that's been glazed into an AI program, it's really hard for the AI program to actually pick out like the character that you drew, or your style, basically, like what you actually drew, because there's so much extra like noise that's been put on top of it. So this is the version of glaze. There's a couple different versions. There is the one that you run through your NVIDIA graphics card if you have an NVIDIA card, and I do, so I have this one. There's another one that doesn't use the NVIDIA graphics card. It does take much longer to run the program on your art, but it's still doable. And then they have the web browser version that I think you need an invitation to use. I'm not 100% sure, because I haven't tried to use it, because the NVIDIA one works fine for me. But if you use the web browser one, it's, to my understanding, is fairly fast. So we're gonna go into the drawings here. We're gonna pick the one that I just finished. So where are you? There you go, preview. So I select the images. You can select more than one too. So your glaze settings, this is how many extra things, not things it can add, but the more intense you glaze the art, the more distorted the final art product can look. Which, if you don't want it to look, the distortions are not that bad, really. And for some art, especially like really textured painted art, you really can't see the glazing on it. But I've been hovering between this, because my art's, it's not really textured, it's not really painterly, so you can kind of see the glaze noise more on my style of art. The render quality is how long it spends glazing it. So because I'm running it through my video card, it actually does not take very long. So I actually go the maximum time, which is around 5 minutes. I'm using the glaze version 1, so it lets you pick which one you want to use. The newer ones, I believe, have more assets used to glaze your art versus the previous one. And then here you select where you want to save it. So I save it into the glaze folder, so I know that those ones are glazed. And then I'm going to run it. So it's detecting my GPU. And then here it's analyzing the image. So we'll wait for that to finish. It won't take very long. And then I can show you guys what the final glazed image looks like. So I've been doing this for images that I post on Twitter, especially, because Twitter definitely has a lot of scraping. Haven't been doing it on all of my socials yet, because I haven't been as worried about them. That's probably dumb of me. I should be doing it everywhere, but like, because Instagram, it's so hard to download images that aren't yours. And DeviantArt, I have it set to not download. So people are just taking screenshots of my art, which is great. Tumblr, maybe I should worry about Tumblr. I haven't been worried about Tumblr. And then TikTok is just videos, so. So here it says it kind of jumps around on how long it's going to take, but a little less than 2 minutes. Originally I couldn't get this version to work for some reason, so I tried the regular version that doesn't require going through your graphics card, and it took like hours. So I'm really glad I got the graphics card version to work. But yeah, if again, if you don't have the right graphics card, they do have a web browser version. I'm just not sure how, because I think it's like in beta, so I'm not sure how you get access to it. But yeah, it'll be great once that is really widely available. The nice thing is the companion piece I want to do for this, I'm going to use the same frame in the background. So I really just have to draw the character and then color them. So that's going to cut down a lot of work. It's just, I can't work on them until you and Soggy catch up. And Soggy need to finish the episodes from last week. Actually, I should go pester Soggy and see if she can watch them on her own or if I need to play them for her tomorrow. It does work? Okay. Okay, so it says that it's successful. And that's in the output folder. So it's in the folder that I chose earlier. So let's go take a look. Okay, so it is here. So this is what it looks like glazed. See, you can kind of see it in here where it's kind of added this extra texture, basically. But if you zoom out to like 50%, like it really just looks like it's been textured, right? It really doesn't look that different from, hang on, let me move this too, from here. Like, it just looks like extra texturing, so it doesn't really look out of place or abnormal. So that's why I said I feel like glaze is really good for this kind of painterly style, with rough colors. Yeah. So that's great. So that looks really good. I'm pretty happy with that. Sometimes it'll tell me here, when it finishes running, it'll be like, oh, weren't able to glaze it enough to protect it from an AI program. Please either increase the intensity or the render quality. So then I'll just have to run it again with a higher intensity. And it'll just replace the previous render that it made. So it's really easy. I'm just really happy that I knew about Glaze when it first came out and just kind of forgot about it. And somebody was talking about it again a couple weeks ago, and I was like, oh, I should start using that and maybe start posting on Twitter again. Because I don't really want to post on Twitter, but I kind of need to post it on Twitter for visibility, right? Just trying to walk that line of doing what I need to do as an artist, as a freelance artist, but also like not screwing myself over. Like, I want to try my best. I want to try my best as an artist, to put myself out there and advertise myself and get clients and everything. But, part of the discussion Dan and I had where I needed to focus art more as a hobby again and not like, killing myself to try and be a really successful artist. That goes in hand with the, how much social media presence do I want to have? Like, do I want to really sacrifice putting my art out there and have it stolen, sort of thing? Who do you think the companion? You think it's Zoe? Why do you think it'd be Zoi? It could be. What if it's Sailor Luna? It's just puppet Artemis. You can just put a hand puppet there. Just the preview for 35. I will say, I think you'll know when you get to it. They'll be like, oh, it's gonna be that. Also, if you don't get it, that's also fine too. But I feel like knowing you, you'll be like, oh, okay, it's that. Okay. Well, we're gonna cut the stream. It's not super short. There's only like 10 minutes for it to be 2 hours. So I'm gonna go ahead and end there because 10 minutes is not enough time to start something new. See, our friends aren't on, so we're just gonna end it here. Thank you so much, Beige. I think she turned out pretty well. I'm happy with her for now. Maybe in like 2 days I'll hate it. Alright, so next drawing stream is Thursday. And if Soggy and V-chan catch up, I will work on the companion piece to this one. If they don't, I'll work on something else. I have lots of things I could work on that I just haven't been working on. And then Friday will be another gaming stream. We'll be taking the group. We're playing Sailor Moon Another Story. We'll be taking the group to Venus's Ark and flying it around. So yeah, thank you guys so much for stopping by, and I will see you on Thursday. Bye.